Thank you. My name is Reverend Andrea Haldeman, and I am blessed to serve the whole of the community here at Lebanon Valley College as the chaplain and coordinator of spiritual life. I wanted to mention that as we prepare ourselves for the performance that continues, as it is offered as a time of reflection, because of this, you are invited, as hard as you may find it to do, to hold all of your applause until the conclusion of the program. Advent is a season of both quiet reflection and joyful expectation. This service is to be intended for a time of spiritual preparation as we watch and we wait for the coming of the kingdom of God. Through our experience of word and music, the story of the coming of Christ and God's unfailing, perfectly all-encompassing love gradually unfolds, thus inviting us to deepen our understanding of God's message of love and redemption offered for all people. The liturgy itself embodies the sense of Advent movement through the beautiful preludes, through the choir's procession, and in the increasingly powerful readings and the promise of the Holy Scripture. May these words and this music propel you quietly toward the true joy of Christmas. And now I would invite you to pray with me. Holy, gracious God, in this holy season of Advent, we wait, for you are coming to us. Now in this season of waiting, we listen, for you, the faithful word, speaks of good news to us. Now in the waiting and the listening, we watch, for you, the faithful Spirit, continues moving among us. When you were tired of waiting, God of the first moment, you tore open chaos so creation might flow unimpeded. Puppies quivering in falling snow, ice for skating forming on ponds, giraffes stretching their necks for snacks. All these fresh and glorious wonders were crafted for those in your image, so we might live in your joy forever. Prophets came so we might hear you and see you at work in our midst. Yet all too often, there are times when we find ourselves turning a deaf ear to them, refusing to notice you. So you came down to us in Jesus, your child of life, simply to save us. In your holiness, you could have stood apart from us, God of compassion and hope, but in your love, you came to us to be one of us in Jesus. When we struggle in despair's poverty, you enrich us with your grace. When we are weakened by fear, you strengthen us with your hope. When we think our lives are empty, you fill us with everything we need. When death thought it had lulled him to sleep, he kept alert, waiting for your resurrection love to gather him up and bring him to new life. Advent Spirit, help to unclog our ears so we can hear the songs of the angels and the children and the young people and the music that will surround us this afternoon. Help wipe away the grit from our eyes so we can see the one who is coming to us. Help those of us who are joyful, those of us who may find ourselves in despair, those of us who grieve, those of us who long for you to be met, filled, and fed with hope, peace, joy, and love, as only you can offer us completely. God in community, holy in one, help us to wait patiently and hopefully as we lift these prayers and praises, humbly offering them to you, to the throne of heaven, in the words that Christ himself has taught us as we pray together, saying, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you. The First Lesson, Just Listen, by Rachel Naomi Remen. I suspect that the most basic and powerful way to connect with another person is to listen. Just listen. Perhaps the most important thing we ever give each other is our attention, and especially if it's given from the heart. When people are talking, there's no need to do anything but receive them. Just take them in, listen to what they're saying, care about it. Most times, caring about it is even more important than understanding it. Most of us don't value ourselves or our love enough to know this. It has taken me a long time to believe in the power of simply saying, "I am so sorry," when someone is in pain, and meaning it. I have even learned to respond to someone crying by just listening. In the old days, I used to reach for the tissues, until I realized that passing a person a tissue may be just another way to shut them down, to take them out of their experience of sadness and grief. Now I just listen. When I have cried, when they have cried all they need to cry, they find me there with them. This is a simple thing, but it has not been easy to learn. I certainly went against everything I had been taught since I was very young. I thought people listened only because they were too timid to speak or did not have the answer. A loving silence often has far more power to heal and connect than most well-intentioned words.
Thank you. The Second Lesson, Snowfall by J. Joseph Paulhill. When snow falls, the world is muffled, vigil kept by the moon. All around we hear the night. The world is muffled. You walk beside me. All around we hear the night. All around we listen. You walk beside me, the snow muffling our steps. All around we listen, and the snow falls on. The snow muffling our steps, I hear you and you me. And the snow falls on as we stand for a moment. I hear you and you me with the wilds of the world muffled as we stand for a moment, we listen. With the wilds of the world muffled, vigil kept by the moon, we listen when snow falls.
Thank you. The third lesson, The Day You Begin, by Jacqueline Woodson. There will be times when you walk into a room and no one there is quite like you. Maybe it will be your skin, your clothes, or the curl of your hair. There will be times when the words don't come. Your own voice, once huge, now smaller, when the teacher asks, "What did you do last summer?" Tell the class your story, and in that room where no one else is quite like you, you'll look down at your hands and wonder, what good is this when other students were flying and sailing and going somewhere? There will be times when the lunch your mother packed for you is too strange or too unfamiliar for others to love as you do, and you'll wonder how they don't see the rice beneath the meat and the kimchi. You'll wonder why she doesn't remember that rice is the most popular food in the world. There will be times when the world feels like a place that you're standing all alone way outside of, and all that stands beside you is your own brave self, steady as steel and ready, even though you don't yet know what you're ready for. There will be times when you walk into a room and no one else is quite like you, until the day you begin to share your stories, and all at once, in the room where no one else is quite like you, up a little wider to make some space for you. This is a day you begin to inside your laughter, your books, your travel, and your stories, where every new friend has something a little like you, and something else so fabulously not like you at all.
Thank you. The fourth lesson, 2:1-7, the birth. In those days, a decree that our Augustus world should be registered. This was the was taken while was governor. Yes, was Syria. When all to be registered Joseph to the city of and to who was expected birth to him and wrapped him in bands of cloth, because there was no place in them in the inn.
Mama said, "What's your first day at school?" No one could say, not even your teacher. Mama asked. She tried. It got stuck in her mouth. Tell your song.
The girl wrinkled her.
Names are songs. Yeah. Sing your name. Your teacher will learn to sing. The next day, I want the girl to school. Songs to teach. Line up, Ms. Anderson hollered. The girl looked to the sky. Ms. Anderson hollered names. Benjamin, Siobhan. The girl sang. The whole stared. asked. I'm singing my name, so you'll learn it. Names are not in Haft. The girl sang her name. The teacher.